When you get on set with someone in scenes like this that require a lot of dramatic work, do you generally give them as much distance as you would a performer that's a veteran that's been working for a while, or do you try to get in it and help and coach as much as possible?
Oh, Cammy needs no coaching. She showed up. This woman has such a deep well within her, and she is so prepared and willing to throw down in game. I mean, I had to go back home and do more homework to keep up with her.
Did you expect that?
Did I expect that he would have to go home and do more homework?
Yeah, were you on set with him like, come on, James, get some homework here.
No, I, of course, I had seen James's films, and when I found out that he was attached, I was like, oh, shit, now I'm really going to have to perform for this and really step up to the plate. But no, it was, you know, working with an actor that is as talented and has as much of a career as James has, it just only elevates your work, I think. And he, as I've said before, but truly mean it, has just been a great support system. On the days that I needed help and the days that I didn't need help, I just found myself looking to him for guidance when I needed it.
Well, okay, James.
Yeah, I just want to say, I mean, what was so important is for us to listen to each other, for us to be present with each other, you know, because all my instincts are going into Hank and all of Cammy's instincts are going into Mickey, and that is the relationship. So it was just this, we took a week beforehand to really kind of all hang out together and build this trust, and we got to know each other in this very... in the simple ways of what are the things you like, the things you don't like, what are the things you wear, what kind of music do you listen to, what do you do at a rodeo? I watched her at her first rodeo. I mean, all these things matter and they inform you, and so then you just run with it together, you know?